always my inspiration is my surroundings. That is the basic principle. Normally, when I'm making heads or things, I mean, I'm traveling, going by train or walking in the vegetable market or food market. So I see various people. So I like some of their characters, some of the features, some of their gestures. Sometimes I'm inspired by a fruit. You know? I like the shape of the fruit, the feel of the fruit, the color of the fruit, and the volume of the fruit. I want to have a simplified form, which I cannot put it in words, but when you are simplifying, you are losing out the detail of the figure what you are seeing, but at the same time you are building up the basic character of the figure. When I am working in clay, that's where I put textures, you know, so that some is smooth area, some is textured line, like you see this braid, they are in the form of braid, so you are breaking the monotony and adding strength to the volumes what I have created. After I work in clay, then I take a plaster mold, then I cast it in polyester resin fiberglass. It's a cold process, and in the initial stages I myself used to do an entire process. Now I have some assistants to help me out in the castings. After the casting, then I take out the cast and then sandpaper it, finish it, and properly check all the details has come out in the casting or not. After that, then I start painting the sculpture. Once I paint, and sometimes I gilt, not always, sometimes I gilt the sculpture with gold leaf and put earrings, nose rings. My primary concern when I'm working is, first I satisfy my own inner needs, then I want my work to be responded by people from my area and also to the rest of the local beauty becomes something universal.